It was September 11th, 1995. A 9-year-old boy named Jimmy Ryce was missing, last seen getting off his school bus and walking toward his home in the Redlands just south of Miami. His parents remember it like it was yesterday.
We kept waiting and hoping he'd come to the house, and he never did. And that was the beginning of 3 months of unmitigated hell while we started looking for him.
For 3 agonizing months, Don and Claudine Ryce looked for their son, posting Jimmy's picture everywhere, only to be torn down.
You know, there'd be pictures of missing dogs and a Jeep for sale, and our son's picture would be thrown in the trash can.
They never gave up hope.
I never quit hoping that he'd be like in the movies, you know, when they bring the little boy home and he's wrapped in a blanket.
But there would be no celebration. On December 9th, 3 months after their son disappeared, came the worst news possible. Jimmy was dead. His killer, Juan Carlos Chavez, behind bars. Cops had a confession.
They told us that they'd found the body.
He had dismembered it.
Our son.
Yeah, he had dismembered it so it wouldn't, he put it in those little black plastic things that little trees grow in. And it was such a small thing, you know, so when it was dismembered, that no one would ever think a little boy was in those 3 tubs.
Chavez led investigators to Jimmy's body near the trailer where Chavez lived, only about a mile away from the Ryce home. He had kidnapped Jimmy at gunpoint and raped him. 4 hours later, when Jimmy heard a helicopter hovering above, he tried to escape, only to be shot in the back. His dismembered body was encased in cement in 3 plastic planters. The South Florida community was in shock.
It is a case that gripped an entire community.
Jimmy Ryce's father had to listen today as a police detective recounted
trying to keep crucial evidence in the Jimmy Ryce murder case.
I remember going out there. It's starting to rain. The heavens are crying. What a beautiful world we live in.
Such a beautiful world. And Jimmy was a flower in it. It was just beginning to open. It was so beautiful.
I didn't even know what I was going to say. It just dripped out of me.
Claudine and Don, who now live in Vero Beach, founded the Jimmy Ryce Center for Victims of Predatory Abduction, an office they run out of their home. 12 years after their son's murder, they're as dedicated as ever to keeping kids safe.
You believe that there is a window of opportunity. There are certain things that kids can do to get away, to protect themselves, and to save their own lives, right?
You got to scream, help, you're not my daddy, you're not my mother, help me, you're trying to steal me, help, help, help. You know, you got to teach them, they have to practice, because it's hard to really scream loud and know the right thing to scream.
They call them Jimmy's Great Escape Maneuvers, or Jimmy's Gems.
There may have been a time when people said, just be passive and maybe they won't hurt you. That's very bad advice. The advice we always give is fight with everything you've got and get away.
The Rices believe children should try their hardest to escape from the moment someone tries to abduct them, even if their lives are being threatened. A conversation Claudine never had with Jimmy.
Even if somebody points a gun at you, you still turn and run. You don't get in the car with them.
But you don't blame yourself for that. You carry any guilt at all?
I feel guilt. I always feel guilt.
The parents will always feel guilt.
The Rices are convinced if police had bloodhounds the day Jimmy disappeared, he would have been found alive. Through the Jimmy Ryce Center, they've donated more than 400 bloodhounds to law enforcement across the country, including the Palm Beach County Sheriff's Office.
We think that's great. We wish we'd had that.
Jimmy's legacy doesn't end there. In January of 1996, with the Rices by his side, President Bill Clinton signed an executive order authorizing the posting of pictures of missing children in federal buildings and national parks. In 1998, the late Florida Governor Lawton Chiles signed the Jimmy Ryce Act to help protect kids from sexual predators. A year later, the first ever Florida Missing Children's Day was held in Tallahassee to remember missing children and those who will never come home again.
There's so many wonderful pictures.
Claudine and Don remember their son as a gifted student who just started 5th grade. He was learning to play the piano and dabbled in art. He painted 3 self-portraits.
He always had a big smile on his face.
Yeah. And he even signed it right here.
Yeah, Jimmy Ryce, age 9.
But Jimmy's true love was baseball.
It's just that whatever he would have been and all of his children would have been, it's not ever going to be. And that's a loss to all of us.
every time we lose one of our children to these sexual predators. And so he was a gift from God. It's just that I wanted to keep him and enjoy his company longer.
In 1998, Juan Carlos Chavez was convicted of kidnapping, sexually assaulting, and murdering Jimmy Ryce. He remains on death row. Lisa Hayward, WPBF News 25.